What? Just like that? Hi, my dear friends. Welcome to the channel Fix Your Mercedes. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button super thanks. And if you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my video as it is fully uploaded, then hit the button join. Thanks. In our today's video, we're going to be talking about the ECU again. As you know, in my recent videos, I've been talking about the ECU, and maybe I told you, maybe not, that I ordered a new ECU, the one that matches my car, because I had to. And let's see now how we have to mount the ECU. How we do that. Okay, the ECU has finally arrived, and now it's time to put it on. Well, if you personally ask me, the easiest part of the job on the whole Ke-Jetronic is more simple than starting a car. Maybe everything looks so complicated, but it's not. This is the easiest job you can do. So you just have to, as this is the ECU for example, you just have to press this thing here and to take out the jack, the connector of the computer. So let's see how it's done. So the first thing we do, we turn the ignition off. Afterwards, we remove the battery ground. And now we are ready to disconnect the ECU and to replace it. To mount the ECU, you see this, and let's say the connector of the ECU has a groove. Let's call it like a groove. So when mounting back, you just have to stick that groove right here and just to put back everything. To push it hard, don't hesitate, and then you can push a connector in order to make sure that everything fits, that each of these pins is on its place in the connector, that nothing is loose, and you're good to go. As simple as that. Well, and now Do we have to replace an ECU? Well, to tell you the truth, the answer is no. Do we feel a difference? Well, the answer is both yes and no. Because I was unlucky, let's say it like that, to have a car made in 1989. And this year, the year 89, is crucial for KE. Because my car is made on 6th month of the year. And in the 9th month of the year 89, in September, we have changes on the system. Well, everything what I'm telling you now about gives me, let's say, an introduction into my video. Something that is going to astonish everyone. I plan to make a quadrilingual video about the Ke-Jetronic system. Because there were 5 versions of this system. And let's say on this topic, on the car made in 89, it's a crucial. There are 2 types of this system. The so-called KE3. I'm going to explain everything in that video. In that, I don't know how long it's going to take, but it's going to be one long and detailed video about that. So, I got this spare part. This one was on my car. Look at them. Just look at them. At these 2. Like 2 drops of water. Except for one thing. They're not made at the same time. For example, the unit I have as a spare part, if you can see here, it says 26/19. So this is the 26th week of 1990. So let's say June 1990. And the one that was on my car, what it says 50/89. So it's the 50th week of the year 1989. That's December. And that's what I've been telling you in that video. My car was ready, manufactured, assembled completely on June 89. And the ECU from that car is from the December. So there is no logic here. It makes no sense. but looks like that someone just what the, how can I say someone had problems with the car, and then okay, just let's replace the ECU and everything is going to be fine. So if you try, that's what something else I wanted to talk about. If you have a car starting from September of 89 up to 1992, then if you have any issues with the car, don't replace these. Don't replace the ECU. You will achieve literally nothing, but nothing. As for me, well, the situation is not the same. I've tested the car and the car runs different. Now, it's not the same. For example, my first start, I have no more these high RPMs of 1200, for example, as in this video, where you can see. But now, the moment I start the car, the RPM fall down to 750, between 750 and 800. There. Did you see that? Here, and the car is totally cold, so no more high RPM and then lowering it. The car fired right up and now it's ready. The car runs different, I think a bit better. That it has better performances. And with this one it was a bit lazy. So I think the mixture is better. I guess. I can just guess. I cannot tell for sure. I must measure everything. But the issue I have now is what you, all of you have been telling me. As I downshift and as I downshift, for example, from third gear to second, and I press the clutch, then the RPM fall down and the car almost stalls. So I had the issue, the bulbs were all on, but the car ran further. It didn't die completely. And now I don't know what I'm going to do either. I'm going to inspect some parts, or I'm simply going to put back the old ECU, because all the parts, all the sensors, all the actuators are on the same place on the newer version of the KE3, both on newer versions, as this one, as well as on the older ones like mine. Well, either I guess what you would tell me, put the old ECU back and you will have no issues. Either I'm going to decide and I'm going to see what I'm going to do. Well, till some other video, happy Mercedes. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.